This past month, I've been feeling really sad and drained. I couldn't even fake a smile for videos, so I allowed myself to do absolutely nothing and just rest. I didn't know what video I wanted to come back with. Originally, I thought that I was going to title this video, Getting My Life Together, but let's be honest, my life isn't together, and that's okay. So today, I thought that I would share some of the little things that I did to help me get out of my slump. Step one is to get out of bed, and believe me, I know how hard this can be. Lately, I've been neglecting my skin, but I'm trying to get back into my skincare routine because I found that when I wash my face in the morning, it helps set the tone for a more productive day. So I thought that I would show you guys some of the skincare products that I've been using lately. This is my new favorite cleanser from Coco Kind. It's super gentle on the skin, but gets the job done. I've also been trying out a new exfoliator from Crave Beauty, which my friend got for me for my birthday, and so far, I've really been liking it. It definitely doesn't replace my Glossier solution, but it's still good. And then for toner, I'm still using the same one from Aquell. I feel like it's lasted me so long, but I'm almost done with the bottle. You guys know that I've been using the Belif True Cream Aqua Balm throughout the spring and summer, but with the change in weather, I've recently switched over to using the Belif True Cream Moisturizing Balm. My skin tends to get pretty dry and dull during the colder months, so the moisturizing balm feels like a moisturizing miracle on my skin. The texture feels velvety and smooth, yet absorbs quickly into the skin without feeling heavy or oily. It instantly improves dullness, uneven texture, and provides up to 26 hours of intense hydration. My skin's left feeling supple, smooth, and glowing all throughout the day. The moisturizer is also available in the Belif Moisture Festival set, which includes the full-size moisturizing balm as well as deluxe minis of the Aqua Balm Hydrating Toner, Moisturizing Eye Balm, and the Aqua Balm Makeup Removing Cleansing Balm. The holiday season is approaching, and this set will be the perfect gift for any skincare lover, especially during the upcoming VIB sale. This kit is such a great value, and if you guys are interested in checking out any of the products, I'll have links to everything in the description, and thank you so much to Belif for sponsoring this video. I've been having really bad insomnia lately. Partially because I just have so many thoughts running through my head, so journaling really helps me just dump whatever I'm thinking or going through onto paper. I have been thinking about wanting to start therapy, but for now, my diary is like my therapist. For me, a clear space equals a clear mind, and as you can see, I've really neglected my physical space over the past month. Whenever I walked into this room, I immediately felt more anxious seeing all of the mess and clutter, so I spent a few hours each day cleaning and reorganizing my space, and by the time I was done, I was already starting to feel better and think more clearly. Thank you. I got this little guy on Etsy and he is just so adorable, oh my goodness, and far less expensive than if I were to buy him off of those big branded plant sites. But can you guys let me know, is this normal when buying plants online? I feel like he's looking a little beat up, but I'm not sure if it's just from the shipping. But you know, regardless, I think that he's a beaut and I am just so obsessed with him, oh my gosh. I think that this might be the start of a new obsession. What I love about reading is that it gives you knowledge, and knowledge is power. Whatever you're feeling or going through, chances are someone else has gone through the same thing and written about it. I recently started writing down key points from each chapter, and I'm hoping by doing this, it'll help me to actually retain the information this time. To be completely honest, I've been treating my body very badly with a mix of undereating and emotional binge eating, so I'm slowly trying to heal and rekindle my relationship with food, but yeah, I would say that this is definitely still a work in progress. So after a few hours, this is what my Notion looks like. It's quite simple because I'm still trying to figure out the platform, but I have my weekly to-do, and then my dreaded expenses, and I still need to figure out how I'm going to set this up. And then for YouTube, I have video ideas, and then I'm currently planning an upcoming What I Eat in a Week video, and I'm using my friend Michelle's template because, this was the first page that I created, and I was quite lost. I'm excited to start using this more. I still need to figure out whether or not I'm going to transfer over my calendar, because right now I'm using Google Calendar. But yeah, this is it. So I realized that this video doesn't have a proper outro, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know that it can be hard seeing highlight reels of people being happy and productive online, so just know that you're not alone and that it's more than okay to not be okay, especially during times like this. I hope you guys are taking care of yourselves, and I shall see you guys in my next one. Bye!